In statistics, we want to learn about a population. But instead of measuring everyone, we rely on only a small sample of the entire group. Then we take what we learn from that sample and apply it to the population. But how large does that sample need to be in order to represent its population? How many people do you need so that the mean of the sample is the same as the mean of the population from which it was drawn? Is a sample of 30 enough? More? We are going to use a massive data set and treat it as a population, and then draw some samples to see how close we get. And the most important thing will be that our sample is randomly selected. This is a huge data set with more than 20,000 cases about patients in a hypothetical intensive care unit. In this data, we have variables like patient age, gender, and the length of their stay. These data have been thoroughly anonymized, de-identified, scrambled for privacy, and these data will be our population. Let's begin by checking out the average age. Right-click on age, or control-click on Mac, and choose Descriptive Statistics. The average age for 20,000 cases is 62.22. The median is 64, and the standard deviation 17.21. Now, we're going to select a random sample of cases. To obtain a random sample, choose Data, Select Cases. This opens the Select Cases dialog box. Select Random Sample of Cases, and then click on Sample. You can now set the criteria for selection. So for example, you could choose a specified percentage of the cases, such as having SPSS choose approximately 50% of the cases. Well, let's go smaller than that. Randomly select only 10% of the cases. All of the unselected cases will be filtered out, but their data will stay in our data set, so they could potentially be selected later, what we call sampling with replacement. Now we check the descriptive statistics again. How did we do? Based on a random sample of 10% of the cases, the average age is 62.48. The median is 65, and the standard deviation is 17.114. Those sample statistics are really close to the numbers for our population parameters. But of course, 2,000 cases is still a huge sample. How much smaller can we go and still have a representative sample? Now, we've heard before that a sample size of 30 is supposed to be a good estimator of the population. All right, let's test that. Let's choose only 30 cases out of 20,000. We will use the recently used dialogs shortcut to get back to Select Cases. Click on the Reset button to clear the previous filter, and then click OK. Now we can go back to Select Cases. This time, we're going to choose exactly 30 cases from the first 20,000 cases. Now, 20,000 is not precisely the total number of cases, but it's close enough. So let's go with that. With our new random sample, we will check the descriptive statistics again. This time, for only 30 cases, the average age is 61.43, the median is 61, And the standard deviation is 14.894. Only 30 cases out of 20,000, and we still got pretty close. Now, obviously, this is not as close as with 2,000 cases, because we have less measurement error with the larger sample than we do with just 30 cases. What if we doubled it, though? What if we chose 60 cases? How much closer would we be? Using the same steps as before, pull up the dialog box for select cases. We want to reset our random selection filter first. Now this time, our random sample of cases will be exactly 60 cases from the first 20,000. So again, we run the descriptive statistics to see how we did. The descriptive statistics for only 60 cases are now 65.62 for the mean, the median is 67, and the standard deviation is 18.091. When we put all of these numbers into a table, we see that the sample size needed to get reasonably close to the 20,000 cases is incredibly small, if it is randomly selected. Obviously, larger sample sizes are better estimators. However, the 60 cases represent only 0.28%, roughly 0.25% of the cases. But if they are randomly selected, they still offer a reasonably good estimate. Why are random samples so powerful? Just like with a kettle of stew, you do not have to eat the whole thing to know if it's properly seasoned. You don't even need to eat a full bowl. If you stir it up first, randomize it, then a representative sample of the stew will tell you everything that you need to know. Now it's time to apply this information. Find a large data set that you are using in your statistics class. Use these techniques to calculate the mean and the standard deviation for the entire data set. And then, choose random samples of various sizes to see how well a small random sample compares to your total data set. You might even try randomly selecting cases by hand to see if you are a good randomizer. How large does your sample need to be to represent the whole data set?